destinies will be realized. Finite chapters will be written. The Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic will come to an end. As one superstar yearns for redemption and a new moon rising, another hopes to prove domination over the rest of the women's division. And in our main event, not only is the NXT championship on the line, but something much greater will be fought for.
Welcome all in one. We are here for our second ever NXT TakeOver event on the WWE 2K18 Universe Mode here on the WrestleDude channel, and we're kicking things off with the finals of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. This is NXT TakeOver Respect, which will have the main event of Roderick Strong versus Drew McIntyre for the NXT Championship. Kicking things off with the finals of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic, TM61 versus the Authors of Pain. And we're getting right into it here. And if you guys would like to skip to any of the matches, I know this is a very long show, but these takeover matches, they seem to go a long time considering this is where the talent is the most aggressive. And you're definitely seeing it here tonight between the Authors of Pain and TM61. So I will be leaving links for all the matches here tonight and what times they start. So if you want to skip to a specific match, you can check that out. I'm sure it'll be the first comment on the video. Also, while you're here, please comment on the video if you enjoyed the show. Drop it a like if you enjoyed, as now we are getting into this matchup. Shane Thorne starting things off against Akam. Shane Thorne takes him over as Akam tried to go for like a double choke slam. Oh, Shane, nice kick. Oh, and takes Rezar off, trying to separate the Authors of Pain. And Shane, drop kick, very nice. TM61 have exploded through this tournament. So have the Authors of Pain. Got to this point by defeating the NXT Tag Team Champions DIY via a countout, especially considering there seems to be an injury involved in that. And look at this, TM61, they're pulling out all the stops here in the early going, looking for the Tower of Doom from off the top rope down, taking down Akam. And this is exactly what they gotta do, just hope something sticks. Throwing all this big stuff right at him. The Authors of Pain, former NXT Tag Team Champions. Oh, and look at this. Oh, I thought they were going to hit him with Thunder Valley, but they couldn't get him all the way up. They got to weaken him a little bit. And the winners of this matchup will be presented with the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic Trophy. This is the first tournament on this Universe Mode. Perhaps it will become a regular thing, as Nick Miller is now the legal man, looks to dive right onto Rezar and trying to get Rezar back to his feet. But meanwhile, Shane trying to yell to him that Akam got back to his feet. And Akam, oh, look at this, from off the top rope, sidewalk slam down onto the canvas below. And now pummeling Nick Miller. And as we said, an injury involved in the tag team matchup between Akam, Rezar, Johnny Gargano, and Tommaso Ciampa. Tommaso Ciampa suffering a knee injury. We will address that on a later episode of the Universe Mode following this episode. But right now, it is all about the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. And right now, TM61's momentum has just shifted into the favor of the Authors of Pain. Oh, and now Nick Miller may have been looking for a hot tag. The Authors of Pain slowing that down in a hurry. The Authors of Pain, you know, a victory here would definitely send them back to become my number one contenders. I mean, heck, if the injury on Ciampa is that serious, we may have to have new champions crowned. Oh, man! And he tried to go for a tag there, and Rezar cutting him off. And you notice, no Paul Ellering tonight. He's been banned from this matchup, thus to ensure that we have a fair winner. Oh, and Nick Miller with a huge clothesline out of nowhere, and makes the tag to Shane Thorne. Oh, nice! TM61 look to be the thorn in the side of the monster that is the Authors of Pain. Shane taking him down. Looks to go to the top. Looks to hit the Phoenix Splash. Here we go. Oh, and Rezar moving out of the way. And the Authors of Pain once again have taken control. Oh, nope. Perhaps not. Oh, perhaps so. Gut wrench suplex takes him down. Rezar lifting him up and tossing him across the ring, but it's towards his tag team partner. That's not a smart idea. Uppercut and a second uppercut, trying to hold him back. Huge strikes, another uppercut, kick, kick, an uppercut, and a running kick takes him down. And here we go, double tags. And here we go, this is where things heat up. Running big boot. And another big boot. Oh, look for a third one. Nick Miller moved out of the way. Side rush and leg sweep. And he makes the tag to Shane Thorne. I think I know what's coming. Thorne gonna try to put him away. Running clothesline takes him down. And Rezar is nowhere to be seen. Cover one, two. Oh, wait. Oh, and he breaks up the pin. Oh. Side Russian link sweep to Rezar. And TM61, they've got him in position. This could be it. Here we go. Looking for Thunder Valley. Here we go. They've got him up. Here we go. Thunder Valley. The move that has sent him so far in the tournament. Can they win it? One, two, no. Shane Thorne knocked out of the ring. And Nick Miller, met with a shot from Rezar. That could have been it. I mean, that move has sent him to the finals already. Oh, and Nick Miller. The crowd are still fired up here. One of these teams is going home with that trophy. Oh, Akam. Oh, big shot to Nick Miller. And look at this. Side Russian leg sweep of his own. Usually that's the prelude to the final chapter, but Rezar is down on the outside. They can't hit it. Uh-oh. Look out. Oh, he was trying to look and set up for that powerbomb. And instead, hits it on Shane Thorne. Thorne took the bullet for his friend. Nick Miller was about to be the one powerbombed. Shane Thorne took the bullet. All to become the winner of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. Reverse DDT. Oh. And now look at this. Nick Miller, look at that strength. Suplexing in Rezar. And Akam. Look at this. Power slam. Oh, no, wait. Rezar. Oh. Rezar's starting to get back to his feet. Akam with a back suplex countering out of the power slam. Ooh. And now he's in there with both Authors of Pain. Oh, Nick Miller reverses. Oh, man. And Miller knocks him off the apron, preventing a hot tag between the Authors of Pain. Drops the fist down. And Miller starting to feel the effects. The longer this match goes, it's like the Authors of Pain, the longer the match goes, the more powerful they become. And just like that. Oh, look at that. A stiff shot from Shane Thorne and a crossbody to the back. Once again, putting his own body at risk just for Nick Miller to get an advancement in this match. But Rezar calling Akam to the corner. Akam makes a tag to Rezar, and Nick Miller is prone on the outside. Shane Thorne nowhere to be seen. Wrestler. Great maneuver. What is this? Spine Buster out of nowhere. Cover. And a kick out by Rezar. Meanwhile, Shane Thorne back up to his feet. We may be in store for another Thunder Valley batten down the hatches. Because I hear the raindrops, and here we go. I hear the thunder, Thunder Valley again. A second Thunder Valley. Cover. One, two, and the three. And TM61 have won the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. They have beaten the Authors of Pain and are presented with the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic Trophy. Congratulations by Triple H. Congratulations to me as well. What a way to start off TakeOver. What an opening match for TakeOver. They went absolutely to the limit. But you know who else is going to take things to the limit? It will be Ember Moon and Nia Jax going one-on-one for the NXT Women's Championship, a rivalry that has been brewing for quite a long time, and it really escalated after Ember Moon slammed Nia Jax through a table off the stage back in the Hammerstein Ballroom. Then it would escalate from there. Nia Jax put Ember Moon through a table, and then it would be a triangle effect. Sonya Deville got involved trying to say she should be the number one contender, and now it finally comes to this. It is going to be Nia Jax versus Ember Moon for the NXT Women's Championship. Will we see a changing of the guard here tonight, or will Nia Jax remain undefeated NXT Women's Champion? Ember Moon hopes to change her luck here tonight. And green indeed is the color of luck in many cultures, but perhaps tonight it may not be enough to put down the undefeated women's champion, Nia Jax. And indeed, she is not like most girls, because most girls on our roster, they show respect. And Nia Jax, she just wants to hurt people. The more people she hurts, the less competition she has, and the less people try and come after her championship. That's her motto. Ember Moon's is just go in there, face who you gotta face, throw everything at them, and try to win. And indeed, that's been helping her ever since. No one has been able to kick out of that eclipse in NXT. And I know if Ember Moon hits that move tonight, we are looking at the next women's champion. Indeed, she does look ready. And Nia Jax looks as intimidating as ever. The women's champion staring across the ring from her challenger, saying, "You want this title? Come get it." And indeed, Ember Moon is not going to pull any punches here tonight. And perhaps Nia Jax may have just been looking one last time at her NXT Women's Championship. Perhaps after tonight, we will see a new women's champion. But let's find out here tonight. Let's get it on. Oh, Nia Jax ran right at Ember Moon. Cover one, two. Oh, I thought it could have been a three count right there. Nia Jax really got stacked up. And Ember, oh man, kick to the back. Ember Moon kind of like grabbing at her ankle. Oh, now sent into the corner. Ember Moon in the early goings with an opponent this tall. Oh man, and this large, you really just gotta break them down, starting at the legs. For Nia Jax, all she's got to do is use that power game. Oh, a drop kick on the outside. It sends her head first off the ring post. Oh, Ember Moon sends her back inside. Oh, going to the top rope. Perhaps could be going for that eclipse early. And Nia Jax rolling out of the way and saying, "I know your A game." Now we're going to start things off in the middle of the ring. Ember Moon trying to go for the eclipse early. Nia Jax had it well scouted. And now she grounds Ember Moon, trying to keep her away from that top rope. Many opponents have made that mistake in the past, to where they've had to keep Ember Moon away from the top rope, and they haven't done a good job of that. Ooh, and Ember Moon, big kick, sending it right at her. Nimmer Moon again, going to the top rope. Oh, and a big boot. And this time, another big boot sends her out of the ring. Man, that did not look like a good fall. I mean, no fall is good, but that one just especially did not look good. And Nia Jax sends her flying into the barricade. The women's championship is what this is all about. And Nia Jax again sending her halfway. Almost into the front row. Landing right by the doctors. Remember, if one of these women aren't able to compete any longer, this matchup will come to an end. And Nia Jax will retain the women's championship if Ember Moon's not able to get back to her feet. And Nia Jax continuing on the assault, working on the back. Looks to hit that waistland and sidewalk slam combination. And instead starts to work the back again with a backbreaker and stretching out the back. Oh, man. Ember Moon, one of the best women's competitors in NXT. Oh, look at this. Sends Nia Jax over the top rope. Nia's in trouble. Ember Moon from off the top rope. Hurricane Rana into the barricade. Nia hit hard. Perhaps not hard enough because she still has the wherewithal to send Ember Moon head first into the LED screen on the ring post. I don't know if that makes it any softer. I mean, would you rather hit an LED board or would you rather hit a metal ring post? And throughout all this excitement here on the outside, I've almost forgotten the count. I've got to get back in the ring. It would suck for this matchup to end in a count out. But it would mean Nia Jax retains the title. Oh, and once again, Nia Jax backbreaker and back stretch combination. Ooh, shoves her down to the mat. Oh, Ember Moon. Oh, hold on, Ember Moon finds her opening. Sends Nia Jax off the ropes, drop kick. But Nia Jax is now down to one knee. And Ember Moon, off the ropes, springboard crossbody. And Ember Moon's finding her footing, but she's gotta stay on her. I know it's exciting knowing you might be closer than ever to becoming women's champion, but you gotta stay on her. Oh, Enziguri trying to hold her off. And huge kicks being delivered, and Ember Moon sees her placement. Nia Jax crawling back up to her feet in the corner. Oh, and the double knees. Double knees. And more kicks, more strikes. She's got her. Oh, she's got her so close. And she's on the ropes. And delivers her own strikes to the back. And Moon. Oh. Trying to ground Nia Jax, trying to hold her down. But I don't know how much that's going to do for an opponent the size of Nia Jax, trying to keep her down. Oh, man. It's like trying to climb to the moon with just using a ladder. Oh, Ember Moon, great maneuver. Oh, spins out. Nia was looking for another one of those backbreaker stretch combinations. Ember Moon flicked out of it and delivers an enziguri. And follows it up with a shot to the outside, double axe handle off the apron. And Moon once again has Nia Jax in position, perhaps for the eclipse. Well, perhaps not, looking for the knees, and Nia Jax moved out of the way. Ember Moon's knees hit the mat hard. Uh-oh. Oh, look out. Nia Jax power bombing her into the mat. Perhaps that could be all. Two. And a kick out by Ember Moon. If it was going to be enough, Nia Jax didn't hit it hard enough because Ember Moon is still fighting somehow. Moon sent into the corner. Oh! Ember Moon, great counter. Now Nia Jax is in the corner. And Nia Jax trying to keep that championship. Look at this. Ember Moon has her up on her shoulders. Holy cow! Michinoku driver! Or I'm sorry, Death Valley driver. But Nia Jax, it doesn't matter. She got a rope break. and that seemingly saved her championship. Nia Jax now wrenching the hair of Ember Moon. Ref, what are you doing? Stop it. Are you kidding me? How is it legal? And Nia Jax. Oh, look at her. A power slam of her own. Oh! And a reversal by Ember may have just saved her. Plants her with a DDT. Oh, and forearms to the face. Look at this. Oh, trying to send her into the corner. Nia Jax fending it off. Oh, went head first into the turnbuckle and a drop kick. Oh, big forearm again to the face of Nia Jax. Oh, and again, massive forearm shots, but none of them are doing any good. But that one slap from Nia Jax is enough to take her down. Here we go, off the ropes. Samoan drop. Will that be enough? Cover. Two. Ooh. And Ember Moon able to kick out. But that three count getting so much closer. And Nia Jax just staring at Ember Moon. Uh-oh. Almost threatening to come off the ropes with a leg drop, perhaps. Oh, off the ropes. Oh, misses with the kick. Ember Moon sends her into the corner. Oh, and again, hits her right on the head. Oh, and Moon backs her into the corner. Oh, look at this, just got her backed up right in the corner. And Ember Moon could be looking for the eclipse. Here we go, Nia Jax rolled to the outside. And instead she hits it. She hit the eclipse on the outside. She's now gonna drag Nia Jax back inside the ring. Nia had the wherewithal to roll out, and Ember Moon said, screw it, I'll hit it anyways. Nia Jax may have just saved her championship, because Ember Moon has to drag her back into the ring underneath the bottom rope. This could be it. Cover. One, two. No, she kicked out. The time delay on that finishing move, the eclipse. Nia had enough time to get back into it and kick out. Oh no, and a jawbuster and a shoulder tackle. Oh man, she was so close. Oh, sends her into the corner. Oh, that does not look good. Oh, Ember Moon, great counter, countered her. Oh, knees from off the top rope. I thought she might have been going for the eclipse. Nia takes her over. Great counter. And look at this. Nia Jax lifts her up. Can she hit it? Wasteland. Here it comes. Go running senton combo. That is it. Cover. And Nia Jax has... Oh, never mind. I was going to say Nia Jax retains the title, but Ember Moon still kicked out. Wow. I was expecting it to be over by then. No one has been able to kick you out of that move. Nia Jax now is just angrier than ever. It's like a grizzly bear. And Nia Jax looks to put her away, perhaps power bombing her. And Ember Moon rolls out. Cover, quick roll up pin. Refs right there. Two. Oh, and she kicked out again. And so Ember trying to go up to the top rope. Nia Jax stops her again. Jump over the top rope and a pinfall again. Can she get her with this one? Two. And another kick out. And Ember Moon, never say die attitude. Drop kick off the second rope. And Nia Jax follows it up with a nice crossbody off the second rope. Nia Jax feeling some effects. Ember Moon with a cry. Primal scream. Spinebuster. Ember Moon, here we go, lifts her up. Side slam. This is it. Ember Moon has won the women's championship. One, two. Oh, a rope break. She was saved by a rope break. I thought that was going to be enough. Oh, Now Nia Jax taking her down with one big boot. Oh, look at her Samoan drop. Ember Moon, great counter. Sends her into the corner. Handspring in the corner. And that's it. This is it. That's the prelude to the Eclipse. Here we go. And the Eclipse. Good night, Moon with the Eclipse. One, we have a new women's champion. Ember Moon is women's champion. Yes, yes, that was awesome. Holy cow, what a move. Ember Moon has just captured the women's championship. Can we get another look at how she hit that Eclipse? What a scene. Ember Moon, the new women's champion. Take a look at this. Boom, the Eclipse. And she was able to lock that arm, keep it away from the bottom rope so she couldn't get a rope break again. Ember Moon is the women's champion, a new champion crowned here tonight at TakeOver Respect. But what will happen in our main event? Will we see another championship change hands? Let's take a look at how our main event came about. With Roderick Strong becoming number one contender and having an incredible career resurgence, NXT TakeOver Respect is set for a stellar main event pitting the Messiah the Backbreaker versus the NXT champion Drew McIntyre. And at the end of the night, one of these men will earn everyone's respect. Supporting the channel. You guys always help me out so much with these episodes as we are here to conclude NXT TakeOver Respect with our main event for the NXT Championship, Roderick Strong versus Drew McIntyre. This match is all about Roderick Strong trying to earn the respect of the champion, Drew McIntyre. And Roderick Strong has impressed many in the WWE and NXT Universe, and anyone who's been watching the episodes of the Universe Mode knows it has been such a long climb for Roderick Strong to get to the NXT Championship, and now he's here facing off against this man, the unbeatable Drew McIntyre, who's been putting out all these open challenges ever since becoming NXT Champion. Fighting off some of the best in NXT, guys like Jack Gallagher, guys like Killian Dane, Cassius Ohno, Hideo Itami. He's beaten Jinder Mahal inside a steel cage in the Hammerstein Ballroom, and now here tonight he faces what I think will be his toughest challenge yet in Roderick Strong. Will Drew McIntyre be able to withstand Roderick Strong here tonight? And oh man, I am excited for this. Roderick Strong looks prepared, but behind that smile he gives to the crowd has to be an anger burning inside of him, knowing that the only thing standing in his way from becoming NXT champion is the man that shows him no respect, Drew McIntyre. And many people think that Drew McIntyre saying he doesn't respect Roderick Strong is just McIntyre trying to give Roderick Strong a reason to come out and fight even harder. That way, when McIntyre wins, he'll know that he beat Roderick Strong at his best. question lies, who's leaving TakeOver tonight as the NXT champion? Who's walking into the rest of the NXT Universe mode as champion? We find that out right here, right now. Nice lock up, and oh, Roderick Strong with a quick arm lock on McIntyre. McIntyre reverses, side headlock. Roderick Strong sends him over off the ropes. Oh, and both men meet shoulder to shoulder. So McIntyre and Roderick Strong have gone back and forth with a war of words on the last episode of NXT before this TakeOver event. Oh, and Drew McIntyre basically saying, bring it. And Roderick Strong saying, after TakeOver, you will respect me. And McIntyre with a Beal throw. Down Roddy, bring it. That's indeed what Roderick Strong is going to have to do here tonight if he wants to try and beat the NXT champion to become champion of NXT. Oop. McIntyre sent him face first into the mat. As we said, McIntyre has held the championship ever since the last TakeOver event on WWE 2K17, defeating Hideo Itami. Roderick Strong, this has to be very surreal for him. At the pay-per-view where Drew McIntyre won a championship, Roderick Strong opened that show, defeating former NXT champion Bobby Roode. And then he would go on to open up another TakeOver event against Hideo Itami, defeating Hideo Itami. Two TakeOver events in a row. Roderick Strong has opened that TakeOver event and has beaten a former NXT champion. Now here tonight, he is closing the show, facing off for the NXT championship. As both men went out into the crowd there for a little bit. Thankfully, it seems as though this fight is heading back towards the ring. That would be a very bad way to end this incredible main event. Oh, and McIntyre up to the top rope with a belly-to-belly out of nowhere. It is vintage McIntyre, to say the least. We've seen that a lot from McIntyre. McIntyre has had a success story of his own, coming back to WWE after being fired, becoming champion. Roderick Strong is having a resurgence in his career. That resurgence will be complete if he's to become NXT champion. Oh man, so what move's gonna put it away? Will it be the Claymore kick? Will it be the Future Shock DDT? Will it be the sick kick? Or will it be the End of Heartache suplex backbreaker? Strong looking for it. Oh, Falcon's arrow. Thought he might have been going for End of Heartache. Definitely could have. He had Drew up. Oh, and there's the Messiah, the backbreaker. Targeting the back of McIntyre. Drew not looking too good right now. McIntyre sent off the ropes. Oh, up into the air and a gut buster down to the mat. McIntyre was focusing on the back. McIntyre may have been bracing himself for another backbreaker, so Strong switches it up and focuses on the stomach, on the gut. And McIntyre starting to get back up to his feet. And so Roderick Strong, taking a page out of Seth Rollins' playbook with the blackout. McIntyre, great counter. Elbow strike right to the gut. And McIntyre starting to find a little bit of an opening. Sends him face first into the mat again. And Strong may have just awoken a beast in McIntyre. Look at this. Side suplex with the arm locked. And McIntyre now finds a focus on Roderick Strong's arm. Oh, and stomps right onto it. Already had so much happen on this TakeOver show tonight. TM61 becoming the winners of the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. A new women's champion being crowned in Ember Moon. Will it cap off with perhaps a new NXT champion in Roderick Strong? I mean, if he keeps kicking out like he did there, definitely so. But Drew McIntyre not letting up at all. Instead, Roderick Strong. Whoop, going to the top rope, and McIntyre meets him there. Precarious position here for both men. And McIntyre from off the top rope. Whoa, rolling down onto the mat. And McIntyre not wasting any time, going right back to attacking Roderick Strong. McIntyre, what is this? Continuing the punishment, gut wrench up off the mat. And smack dab right down back onto the mat. Oh, and Strong still able to kick out. So much punishment in just a short amount of time. First going off the top rope, then those punches to the head, and then the gut wrench, and still able to kick out. And now McIntyre, oh, look for a kick. Strong, great counter. And Strong with a big forearm strike, continuing on. Oh, McIntyre, great counter. Oh, lifts up Strong, here we go. Oh, white noise. Shout out to his buddy Sheamus. Cover one, two to retain the championship, and a kick out by Strong. McIntyre thought he could have put him away with white noise right there, but to no avail. Oh, Strong. Oh, nice uppercut. Oh, and a big knee strike. And Roderick Strong rocked McIntyre. And Roderick Strong tries to take advantage. McIntyre sends him out onto the apron. What is this? McIntyre. Oh, oh, DDT on the apron. And the screen flashed red. I think Strong maybe busted open. He went head first onto the apron with a DDT. McIntyre, though, wasting little time. Gonna send him back inside the ring. I don't think we can get a good look at his face, too. Oh, and he kicked out. And indeed, he is. Is he? I can't tell. I don't know. Oh, and McIntyre, he's now clobbering Strong in the face. I can't tell. Is he? Yep, he is indeed wearing the crimson mask. Roderick Strong's been busted open. This is where we start to get into dangerous territory here. If a superstar gets busted open, referee may have to stop the match due to blood loss. We can't have any superstars passing out. Strong fighting out of the corner. Oh, ooh, running chop. And Strong somehow finding his way back. Strike to the back of McIntyre. And now what is Roddy thinking here? Oh, knee strike to the head. And that cut, we gotta make sure that doesn't get any worse. But perhaps McIntyre's predicament is worse. A backbreaker off the top rope. Onto that top turnbuckle. McIntyre, maybe out. No, instead. Strong, still not enough to put him away just yet. A backbreaker off the top rope. Right into that top turnbuckle. Strong is using every part of the ring, much like McIntyre did with that DDT. Oh, McIntyre, look at this. Reverse suplex down onto the mat. And McIntyre says it's over. The NXT champion may be looking to set him up for that Claymore kick. Strong's in the opposite corner. McIntyre's saying it's over. The crowd are on their feet. They're ready for it. Here we go. Strong, you better not want to get up. Claymore on the way. Oh, knee strike out of nowhere. Spinning knee strike from Strong. And it's still not enough to put him away. Roderick Strong almost lying in wait. Claymore kick was on the way in a jumping knee strike. Strong. Now look at this. Another knee strike with McIntyre up against the ropes. A little bit of a whiplash effect, perhaps. Ooh, and a forearm strike. And another one. Oh, may have been looking for that suplex backbreaker. Ooh, and McIntyre, great moves. Sticking it to him. McIntyre dropping Strong on the top rope. And McIntyre, oh, huge elbow right to the head. Continuing on this assault. McIntyre trying to hold on to that title. like I said, Roderick Strong is becoming the hardest challenge to date for Drew McIntyre. As he continues on the punishment with Roderick Strong, sit-out bomb in the corner, and Strong able to kick out still. And that cut is starting to get bigger and bigger on his head, more and more pouring out. The human body can't go that long with immense blood loss. Oh man, but if there's any man that can fight through it, it's Roderick Strong. But perhaps I could be wrong here tonight. McIntyre, oh, returning the favor. Strong, you want to focus on my back? I'll focus on your ribs. And McIntyre lifts him up. Oh, and drops him on the knee again. And McIntyre, his back's starting to give out from doing all these maneuvers. But instead, of trying to regain himself, he does it again, continuing punishment. Oh, Strong, try to fight that off. Look at this, elbow strike combination. And follows it up with a clothesline. Roderick Strong will not give in. Oh, and a stiff kick to the back. Knee drop to the chest. The champion is being rocked here. He's on wobbly legs and follows it up with another backbreaker. And look at this, Olympic slam shout out to the 2K18 pre-order bonus star Kurt Angle too, and a kick out by McIntyre at 2¾ almost. And McIntyre somehow holding on, the champion trying to hold on to his title. Look at this, rolling up racket. Trying to roll up Strong, trying to get a quick win, perhaps, to retain his title. It's very rare that we see that out of the champion. Oh, McIntyre. Oh, what is this? Ooh, butterfly suplex. I thought he might have been trying to go for McIntyre's own Future Shock DDT. What is this? Strong on the top rope. What are we seeing here? Oh, Bronco Blockbuster from off the top rope cover. Two. Ooh, a kick out again. Man, these guys are going for a long time. Strong lifting up Drew. Oh, nice maneuver by Drew. Like I said, he's trying to hold on to that title. Looking for the Future Shock DDT. Strong for a counter. Counters out. Gutbuster. Great counter out of the Future Shock. Cover. One, two. Oh, and a kick out again. Again. McIntyre had his head locked. Roddy slipped out and hit that gutbuster. Perhaps didn't get him up enough. His ribs are hurt from all those drops. Oh, McIntyre with a stiff punch right to the head. And McIntyre. Roddy knocked over the top rope. Oh, and that cut's getting worse and worse. And McIntyre gonna fly to retain his title, putting everything on the line. A dive over the top rope. And McIntyre celebrating on the outside. Oh man, these guys are doing everything and everything in their arsenal. Sheesh. How are these guys gonna come out of this unscathed? I mean, heck. At this point, it's... Oh, wait a minute. McIntyre taking apart the announcer's table. I was going to say, no matter who wins this match, it's going to be who comes out of it with the least amount of injuries. Right now, I'd say Drew. Oh, wait a minute. Nope, never mind. They're back to square. Drew McIntyre just got dropped onto the apron. Back first. Uh-oh. And Roderick eyeing the announcer's table that Drew just took apart. What is this? Oh my god! Oh! Backbreaker through the announce table! Once again, targeting the back. Sidewalk slam through the announcer's table. And the crowd chanting, this is awesome indeed. This is awesome. Roderick Strong may be closing in on the championship. He's got to put him back in the ring though. Referee's at count of six. He's there. Shoots the half. Rolls him over. Two. Oh, what a kick out again from McIntyre. Again he kicks out. Roderick Strong, he doesn't know what to do. He does not know what to do. And indeed, what would you do at this point? You've inflicted so much punishment, and yet McIntyre's still coming back like a Scottish cyborg. Oh, man. And McIntyre again, just like I said, driving Roderick Strong into the corner. He wants to keep the NXT Championship. Look at this, unloading punches on the already bloodied Strong. Opening up that cut even more, and a knee strike into the head. What is this? Follows it up. Vertical suplex. When he goes vertical like that, all the blood rushes to his head momentarily. Looking for a pile driver, perhaps. Roderick Strong rolls him up. Referee's right there. Cover one. And a kick out. Perhaps not a good grip on that pinfall. Strong off the ropes. Belly to belly throw. I wouldn't even call that a scoop slam. Strong sends him off the ropes. Ooh, big shot. And Roderick Strong clubs to the gut, follows it up with a nice clothesline. This is not good. Roderick Strong, perhaps it may be just that time to say, I quit. Look, his head is busted open even further now from all those punches from McIntyre. What is this? Now on the top rope. And once again, just like I said, all the blood rushing to your head. Stalling superplex. It's a long way from the top for Roderick Strong. Vertical stalling superplex. And that may be it. Ref's right there. One, two. No, again, Strong kicked out. And McIntyre, the doubt starting to settle in. What do I have to do to put him away? Slowly but surely dragging him to his feet. Roderick Strong kneeling to the champion. Perhaps a sign that he's given up. McIntyre! Oh, pile driver! Smack dab onto his head. And that is it. No, it's not! What the hell? He kicked out of a pile. His head is friggin' busted open. And he just kicked out of a pile driver. These men are insane. All this for the NXT Championship. McIntyre doesn't know what to do. So instead, he just keeps going right on attacking Roderick Strong. Continuing on with these stiff shots. Looking for the headbutt. And Roderick Strong able to counter. And drives him into the corner. Oh, McIntyre. Oh, set right back down. Right down with a huge chop. And McIntyre. Oh, sends him into the corner. Oh, McIntyre missed with a knee. Strong. Capitalizing. Oh, Jesus. Backbreaker. Off the top rope. Backstabber. And Drew McIntyre put his foot on the bottom rope. McIntyre went upside down and Strong hit him with a huge backstabber. And Roderick Strong is getting PO'd. That anger. He's turned red with rage. Here we go. Knee strike in the corner. And look at this. Suplex face buster into the mat. And that's usually the prelude to the end of heartache. Here we go. Strong says it's over. It's over. Here we go. End of heartache. Cover. No, Roddy, what are you doing? He's too tired. Roddy, get up. You got it. You can win it. You can win it right here. Pin him, pin him, pin him. He's got it. He's got it. There it is. One, two. No, a kick out of that. How is that not a three? How is that not a three count? Seriously, that was way too close. Roddy just doesn't know what to do. He says, bring it on, champ. One last act of defiance. And it still wasn't enough. Runs into a headbutt. And this is it. McIntyre setting him up. Claymore kick. Oh, no, wait. Strong, great counter. Running clothesline, taking both men down. Strong. Now climbing the top rope again. Elbow drop to the gut. Strong trying everything. McIntyre's down, and look at this. Now the stronghold being applied. Formerly the Lion Tamer by Chris Jericho, now renamed the Stronghold by Roderick Strong. McIntyre might tap. Oh, no, wait. Great counter. Rolls out of the stronghold. McIntyre. Oh, maybe setting up for the Claymore kick again. Oh, no, a knee to the back of the head. And McIntyre. Oh, Strong, great counter. Look at this. Sets him up again. Here we go. Face buster into the mat. And Roderick Strong. Oh, man. So much has happened to this match. Oh, was looking for End of Heartache again. McIntyre sets him down with a huge chop. McIntyre strikes into the skull. Every strike is opening up Roddy even more. I mean, once this match is over, we're going to have to get somebody in there to glue up Roddy's head. And another headbutt. And that is it. Roderick Strong tried his best. And indeed, here we go. Looks to put him away. Strong. Good night, says McIntyre. Future Shock. No way. Roddy rolled out. He flipped out. End of Heartache. He countered the Future Shock DDT. Strong's. He's got it. We have a new NXT champion. Roderick Strong is the new NXT champion. Holy cow, what a match. What an ending. Look at all the stuff that happened in this match. Wow. Look at that backbreaker off the top rope. My God. That jumping knee strike. All of it. Leading to this one final moment. This one last ditch effort. Countering out of the Future Shock. Check this out. Flipping out of the Future Shock DDT and setting him up for the End of Heartache. And Roderick Strong is the new NXT champion. Roderick Strong, look at that bloody face and all. And through the crimson mask, he sees the gold, which shines before him. Drew McIntyre has lost the NXT championship here tonight. And we have a new NXT champion, and his name is Roderick Strong, baby. My God, what a battle between these two incredible competitors. Roderick Strong has just proven here tonight why he deserves to be here in NXT. He is now the top man in NXT. Roderick Strong is NXT champion. And wait, what the hell? What the? Is that Alexander Wolf and Killian Dane? What the hell is this? What are they doing here? They're attacking McIntyre on the rampway. Strong's trying to get glued up by a referee in the ring. What the hell are these guys doing here? What is going on? And Roddy, who the heck is that a fan? Well, the referee in there is trying to glue up Roderick Strong. I think that's a fan that like jumped through the crowd. I can't tell. Wait a minute. I've seen that tattoo before. Who the heck is that? Oh, what the? It just hit the ref. Roderick Strong doesn't even know what the heck's going on. I think that's a fan that like jumped the barricade. He's attacking the ref. Where is security? Seriously. What the heck is going on? This fan just, I don't think this is a fan. Wait, what? That's who? Oh man, a big, I'm getting word, that's Eric Young. Eric Young is back. I haven't seen him since. This guy got rammed off of a ledge in an ambulance. I thought he was in an ambulance crash. And he's just attacked the NXT champion, Roderick Strong, and the referee. Oh, what a dropkick to the referee. Killian Dane and Wolf just took out McIntyre. And Eric Young is standing over the NXT champion. What the hell is going on? Oh, and Young once again striking Strong. He tried to get up, trying to help that official. And Eric Young now with the championship off the skull of the official. What the heck is going on here? This is ridiculous. And Eric Young now has his sights set on the champion. Roderick Strong with the newly won NXT championship off the skull. What is going on here? Where, seriously, where the heck is security on? Oh, wait a minute. Security is being blocked by Wolf and Dane. Security is trying to get past Alexander Wolf and Killian Dane, but they're not letting them. Eric Young is continuing this assault on both the official and Roderick Strong. Another title shot off the skull. And he finishes it off. Wheelbarrow neckbreaker to Strong. What the heck does this mean? Look at the replay here. This wheelbarrow neckbreaker on Roderick Strong. What the heck does this mean? Eric Young is back on NXT's Universe Mode, and he has just targeted the new NXT champion, Roderick Strong. What the heck does this mean?